In this video, I'm going to show you how to carry out a one-way ANOVA within groups or one-way ANOVA repeated measures using SPSS statistics as well as interpret and report the result from this test. Okay, so here I have an example where researchers want to know if four different drugs okay lead to different reaction times. Okay, so to test this, they measure the reaction times okay in second for 5 patients on the 4 different drugs. Okay, so they want to determine okay if the mean reaction time differ between the drugs. Okay, so for this question, okay, we're going to use the SPSS repeated measure, okay, because we are using the same subject, okay, for different condition. Okay, so first of all, open up your SPSS. So here I have a label the reaction times for the 5 patients on the 4 different drug treatment, okay, drug 1, drug 2, drug 3 and drug 4. Okay, so fill all the requirement needed. Okay, so once finished, go to data view. Okay, to key in your data into the cells under each of the column. Okay, so here I have insert direction times when the patient using drug 1, drug 2, drug 3 and also drug 4. Okay, so the next step is we're going to do the analysis. Okay, so to analyze the data, select analyze, click general linear model and then choose repeated measures. Okay, so this will open up the repeated measure defined factors dialog box. Okay, so in the within subject factor name here, okay, we're going to replace the factor 1 here with the name that is more meaningful name for your independent variable. Okay, so as in this case, I'm going to change it to drug. Okay, since the drug is the differs between the 4 reaction times made by each respondent. Okay, so under the number of level here, okay, you should key in the numbers of level, okay, the number of times that the dependent variable has been measured. Okay, so in this case, I'm going to enter 4, okay, which represent the condition at drug 1, drug 2, drug 3 and also drug 4. Okay, so next, click add, okay, to enter them into the empty box by the side here. Okay, and then I'm going to put appropriate name for the measure name here. Okay, the appropriate name for my dependent variable. Okay, so in this case, I'm going to label my dependent variable as reaction time. Okay, so click add. Okay, and then click on define. Okay, so now, okay, we have the repeated measure dialog box. Okay, so we're going to shift, okay, the within subject variable here over to the within subject variable drug. Okay, drug box here. Okay, so you can drag and drop it, or you can use the arrow here. Okay, so you have to make sure that each of this variable is maintained in the correct order. Okay. Okay, so 1 for 1, 2 for 2, 3 for 3, and 4 is for 4. Okay. So once done, okay, click the plots button here. Okay, so to open up the repeated measure profile plots dialog box. Okay, so we're going to move the drugs here under the factor to the horizontal axis. Okay, so click on add. Okay, so this will move the variable into the plots dialog box here. Okay, so you can choose the types of the chart that you want. Okay, either line chart or bar chart. Okay, so I'm going to choose a line chart. Okay, and then click on continue. So next, click on the EM means here. Okay, so this will open up the repeated measure estimated marginal means. Okay, so I'm going to move the drugs under the factors and factor interaction here to the display means for. Okay, tick on the compare main effect. Okay, so under the confidence interval adjustment, okay, I'm going to choose Bonferroni. Okay, and then click on continue. So next, click on options. Okay, so here I'm going to choose, okay, the display that I want in my output. Okay, so I'm going to choose for descriptive statistic and estimates of effect size. Okay, so the significance is 0.05. So click on continue. Okay, so lastly, click on OK to view the test result. Alright, so here we have the test result for our within group ANOVA. Okay, so the first table here remind us of the groups of our independent variable. Okay, the label of the drug point. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and here in the dependent variable column here, we have the dependent variable. Okay, our reaction time that measure at each of this drug point. Okay, the next table is the descriptive statistic table. Okay, so this table simply provide us the important descriptive statistic for the analysis. Okay, we have the mean, the standard deviation, and also the number of subject. Okay, for each of the reaction time at the different time point. Okay, so the next table, the multivariate table. Okay, this table is not necessarily important in the interpretation of the ANOVA. Okay, so we can ignore it at this point. Okay, so move to the next table here. Okay, so this table will provide whether the assumption of the sphericity has been met. Okay, so like Lewin test for independent t-test, okay, we do not want the multi-test to be significant. Okay, so to see, okay, whether the multi-test is significant or not, okay, we're going to see or look at the significant value here. Okay, so if the significant value is more than 0.05, okay, so the assumption of the sphericity has been met. Okay, if the value is less than 0.05, okay, means that the multi-test is significant. Okay, therefore the sphericity has not been met. Okay, so this table is actually concurrent to the next table here. Okay, the next table here we have the test of within subject effect. Okay, so if our multi-test was non-significant, okay, so we will read across from the sphericity assumed. Okay, however, if the multi-test has been significant, then we would need to use, okay, one of the other rule here. Okay, normally we're going to choose for a greenhouse geyser. So as in this case, okay, since the sphericity assumption was met, okay, so we're going to use the sphericity assumed rule here. Okay, so look at the significant value here. Okay, so since the significant value is less than 0.05, okay, so therefore we can say that there was a significant main effect of the reaction time on the four different drug. Okay, so we have the F value here, 24.759. okay, and the degree of freedom is 3 and 12. Okay, alright, so this two table, okay, we can ignore it at this time. Okay, so we're going to move to the estimated marginal means here. Okay, so this box will show you the breakdown of the mean for the different level of your independent variable. Okay, so the mean value here is same as those displayed in the descriptive statistic box at the beginning here. Okay, so the value is the same. However, this box also will give you the standard error for your different condition. Okay, so the next table here, we have the pairwise comparison. Okay, so it carries out the multiple comparison between every possible combination of pair for your condition. Okay, if the ANOVA result, okay, tell you there is a significant effect of reaction time, okay, so this table will exactly tell you, okay, which pair of condition are significantly different from one another. Okay, so remember that the number here, okay, so the number here refer to which condition. Okay, so we have a drug one, okay, reaction time when using drug one, reaction time when using drug two, reaction time when using drug three, and reaction time when using drug four. Okay, so reading this table is actually very simple. Okay, so in the first column here, okay, we can see the list of our four condition. Okay, so for each of this condition, okay, we can read the across for each of the row to see which group are being compared. Okay, for example, 1 and 2, okay, drug 1, drug 2, drug 1 and drug 3, drug 1 and drug 4, okay? Alright, so to find out, okay, whether this comparison are significant, okay, we're going to look at the significant column here, okay, and also the asterisk in the mean difference here, okay? So remember that the value, the significant value, need to be less than 0.05 to be significant. Okay, so therefore, for this example here, we can see that there's only a two significant difference between the pair. Okay, so between the drug 1 and drug 4, and also drug 3 and drug 4 here. Okay, so the multivariate test, we can ignore it. Okay, so we're going to move to the final part of the output, okay, the mean plot here. Okay, so this actually will help you to visualize your result, and it is a good idea to include it in your write-up. Okay, so here we can see that the highest reaction time will observe, okay, when using drug 4, okay, followed by drug 1, drug 2, and the lowest reaction time will observe when using drug 3. Okay, so this is how we do the interpretation of the result for the within group ANOVA.